Just because Chris Young titled his latest album AM doesn't necessarily mean the singer is fond of getting up at the crack of dawn.
You know, that's probably the only thing about this record that's just grossly inaccurate, because it makes it seem like I love the morning, which I don't. I'm totally like the other end of AM, which is like you stay up past midnight.
But in the AM, they go from getting buzzed into wasted. Might not remember what they're saying. Radio turned up and playing loud, a honky-tonk station.
Usually when people ask me, and especially in the past, you know, they go, why did you make this the title of the record? And I have some total BS answer that is like, yeah, this is the title because it, you know, I thought it encapsulated what the record meant. And on this record, it really is the truth. AM, you know, as a song, is a great song. But then the reason I wanted that title is there's a lot of stuff on this record. There's party songs. There's Lonely Eyes, about seeing somebody for the first time, just kind of being drawn to that person.
Those lonely eyes don't have to be alone tonight.
Hold You to It was a song kind of, you know, I just want to dance with you style song. There's a song called Goodbye that's about, hey, I know you came over late to tell me we're breaking this thing off, but I think we're too good for this. We gotta stay together. Even in Goodbye, there's a lyric that says it's about 11:30. Everybody always says nothing good happens after midnight, but there's a whole bunch of stuff that happens after midnight that's great. It's like these huge life-changing moments. And I thought, you know, man, all these songs kind of could fit into that, and that's a great album title.
In fact, when it comes to life on the road, the Night Owl is first to admit he's learned some of his biggest life lessons in the dark.
Some of my best shows happen after midnight. Just about every time I've ever played a New Year's Eve show, it hits midnight. We're still playing after that. The show doesn't stop. So, yeah, I think that's a big part of it, too. You know, there's a lot of life moments that I've seen out on the road or that I've experienced that happen late. And it just, I think, bled through a lot on this record. So far, what I've seen, and hopefully as well, something that people are going to relate to, they're going to click in with.
All I can think about is getting you home.
Known primarily for his slow to mid-tempo romantic ballads like Getting You Home, Tomorrow, and You.
I never found anything that makes me feel like I do.
Young says this time around, he made a conscious effort to speed things up.
I think the two most important things with this record were really not only more tempo, but also making it feel more like one of my live shows. Because most of my singles have either been, you know, ballads or mid-tempo stuff. Even if it was an up-tempo, it wasn't really, you know, what On Awe is. There wasn't that double guitar sound, which is a lot of stuff that I do live. So I think more so than any of the other records, this is kind of encapsulates what a live show is. People listen to this record and they're into it, they need to come see a show.
Walking through the front door, sing your...
It's a little bit different than what I've done in the past, and I think that's what you have to do. You know, you can't keep doing the same thing over and over and expect the same result, because people just get tired with it. So. Was it a little bit of a risk going with something that's, you know, two guitars, super tempo, weird title, like All in All as a first single? Yeah, but so far it's working.
All in All, somebody just bought a shot of that Patron. Hang on, we've been here all night long. All in All.
With co-writes on more than half of the album's 11 tracks, including the infectious All in All, Chris's evolution in the genre is rising as fast as his singles on the charts.
It's all about constantly just bettering what you did before. As long as you're doing that or you're doing your best job at that, then you're doing it right. So it's just continuing to build fans and, you know, obviously getting the word out about this new record, hoping people really dig this as much as they've dug the past couple, and, you know, hopefully more so. I really feel like I put the time and the work into it, so now it's just about getting it out there where people can get a hold of it and listen to it.
And if Chris has any doubts that fans are in fact listening, the Tennessee native says they are quickly put to rest whenever he leaves the house.
That is the one drawback to this song, is that now people come and they're like, oh no, man, you know, just constantly. But it's a, yeah, I'll take that for having a hit. You know, I'll take people coming up and spouting the album title at me for the rest of my life.
Oh, no.